Patty, and I'm fairly new here to Renaissance Church. And a couple weeks ago, listening to Pastor Julian's message, I really was impacted, and I really felt like, man, I really want an unstoppable moment. And so I've been praying for one. And it was a Sunday evening, it was rainy, it was cold, and I didn't want to go out. But I really felt like God said, what kind of unstoppable moment will you have if you're sitting at home? And so I thought, okay, well, I don't really need to go out. And it turns out that I was out of toilet paper at my house. And I said, well, kind of have to go for that one. And so I said, okay, let's go. I went to Walmart and I said, God, whatever moment you have for me, help me to be aware. And so as I walked into the Walmart, my local Walmart here, I saw a girl and she was working there, and she didn't look too happy. And so God automatically said, there's your moment right there. And I'm like, but what am I gonna do? You know, so I started questioning, and I did what I think all of us do. I said, well, is she still there when I check out? You know, and so I went around the store looking for what I had, needed to get, and of course some extra things. And I thought about her the whole way. I'm like, what am I gonna say? What am I gonna do? How do I approach this? This is kind of awkward. And I checked out and I said, well, hopefully she's still there. If she is, I'll talk to her. If not, well, you know, maybe it wasn't meant to be. As I was walking out the door, I saw her and she was at the door kind of greeting people. And I could tell by the look of her on her face that she was not happy. And I walked right past her and I stopped. And I heard God's voice say, go back. And so I said, okay, God, I'll go back. And I went up to her and I saw her name tag, and her name was Emma. And I looked at her and I said, hello, Emma. And she just looked at me and she was kind of giving me this look like she didn't know who I was. And I said, this is gonna be weird, but I really felt like I needed to tell you something. And I feel like it was God compelling me to tell you. And she just looked at me and I couldn't tell by the look on her face whether she was happy or sad. And I said, God wants me to let you know that he has something better for you. And the look on her face, she just kind of turned red, and there was a moment of silence. I thought it seemed like forever, and tears started to stream down her face. And I said, I don't know if you believe in God. I don't know if you believe in prayer, but it doesn't matter because I do. And I'm gonna be praying for you. And I know that right now is not the right time because you're working and people were walking past her. And she just looked away and looked back, and her face is just, her eyes were filled with tears and they were streaming down. And I said, is there anything specific that I can pray for you about? And she just said, my life. Just pray for my life. And she turned around and walked away. And I went into my car, and of course I got all these insecure thoughts of, I could have done more, I should have done more, I should have said this, I thought of scripture. All these things came flooding through my mind, and I kind of felt defeated, and I sat in my car and I just cried out to God, God, please be with Emma. God, maybe I wasn't the first person to approach her, but I pray that I'm not the last. God, I pray that maybe just she has a little bit of more hope than she had before. And I prayed for her, and you know, I haven't seen her since. I've gone back to look for her, but I haven't seen her. But I've been praying for Emma, and God really just put on my heart, it doesn't matter what you do, as long as you take that step of faith. And continuing to pray that I wasn't the last person and that next person could be you. So that's my unstoppable moment.
Take the unstoppable challenge, because someone's life will change through you, because you had the courage to allow Jesus to change yours. Let's be the unstoppable church that Jesus intended us to be.